Hello, I'm Jerry Goodspeed.
And I'm Sheridan Hansen.
We're the couple of the garden guys and gal.
Yep.
And we're here to talk about one of our favorite pests.
Favorite pests?
Least favorite pests. I saw the other day there was an earwig above my door, and all of a sudden I heard this great big BAM! And it was Sheridan smashing the earwig.
With no shoes on, because I was using my shoe as earwig control.
I thought that was a hammer. A lot of people don't like earwigs.
I don't like earwigs, and you can see why. We're here in the Urban Farm Demonstration Garden at the USU Botanical Center, and we have had a huge problem with earwigs this year. And I know a lot of people out there have had the same problem, because we're hearing all of these questions coming in about earwig damage on our Facebook group, Utah's Gardening Experts.
And you can see it really good on your eggplant.
You can.
I'm kind of the opinion this is how we control eggplant, but but a lot of people like eggplant.
We're using eggplant as a trap crop.
Yeah, that's not true.
No, it's not.
We're trying to grow eggplant.
We want this eggplant because we our intention in this garden is to donate some of this produce to needy families. And a lot of some of our international friends that come from different places, our refugee friends, like eggplants.
They love it. Yeah.
I like to have some eggplant for them.
And I've eaten it once when it was okay.
Yeah. It was like really coated with stuff.
Yeah,
fried,
deep fried.
You couldn't tell it was eggplant. Yeah, so you can kind of see the damage that happens. It's called skeletonization, pretty much. They come and they just destroy the leaves.
All that's left is that midrib.
Yep, and that really tough, chewy part that they don't want to eat. So they even have a preference.
Yes. Yeah, they do.
So there's a few ways that we can control these guys.
One of the ways that I do it, which you might call organic, if you will, is I'll take a piece of cardboard. This is what it looks like in the end, and I'll roll it up like this, this is one from Amazon. Everybody has them in their yard,
yep.
Or in their house.
Yard. I hope not in their yard.
Well, sometimes.
It's
but,
been the only place you can really shop lately.
Everybody's got a Amazon box. I should show. That's about the size that I use. You can use bigger. And I'm going to build them a little nice home that they want to go into in the day.
Very nice.
It gets hot and dry. And so I will simply roll it up. Take a rubber. Sometimes what I'll do is I'll put a little bit of moisture in there. I'll just take my hand and go ch-ch.
And then they like moisture.
They love moisture.
And you can see we have drip line here, and it keeps it really wet around the plants. And so they just go right.
And if you're, and it's good to use a mulch, but if you use a mulch,
they like that too.
Yep. So there you go. And then I will throw that
right there. I'll
just put them right there so that when they're done eating and they're full, they want to go sit down in their home. They'll crawl in there in the morning.
Ooh, they take a nap.
Yeah, like me. They take a nap. They crawl in, they say, oh, and then they take a nap. And then in the morning, you can just pick it up and throw it away.
Carefully.
Yeah, they'll pull out. So sometimes what I've done even is have a bucket there where I throw these into and then empty the bucket. Actually, what I do is I kill them before I
soak them in water
I drowned
the
them. So yeah.
Another way you can do this, and you know, we should mention, if you have problems with earwigs in trees, this is a great way to control them in the trees. Instead of making this little round thing, so if you've got fruit trees, we can actually just wrap
that
right around the trunk and secure that around the trunk. And
I use a cable tie with it.
Yeah, and they'll go right in there, and you can do the same thing on your fruit trees, because they like to attack peaches and all kinds of stuff. Another way you can do this is with newspaper. You just take several layers of newspaper and you can wet it again, just like Jerry mentioned.
I normally do, just a little bit of moisture.
Yep. And you can roll this up, same kind of deal. They like all these little layers and cavities, little places where they can kind of hide.
I found that they like the sports section best. But
they like the sports section? I was thinking the comics.
Well, that might be true.
Maybe, you know, international crisis section, because look at what they did to my
plant.
Because
look what they're doing.
Yeah. And then if this doesn't work, there are some other things we can do. Oh, we forgot to mention the tuna can.
And I didn't bring the tuna can.
You didn't bring the tuna can. So another way that you can do this, you can bait them with a tuna can.
Yeah.
So you take the top off, empty out the tuna, have it for dinner, leave some of that.
The tuna, not the can.
Yeah, not the can. Leave some of that oily stuff in the can.
Residue.
Yep, add a little bit of.
I usually put a little bit of bacon grease if I have it.
Yeah, if you have
And
that,
I always have
soy
bacon grease.
Soy sauce works too.
Soy sauce is another good one.
And then
alcohol will even work. A little bit of beer sometimes will work.
Beer will work, definitely. Yeah. And the cheaper the beer, the better. And, add a little
no
bit
class
of,
on those earwigs.
No class on the earwigs. Add a little bit of vegetable oil, and they'll go, and you have to bury it so it's flush.
So it's flush with the soil.
With the soil, and they'll go in there at night, and they'll go into the oil, and they can't get back
out.
And you'll come out in the morning, and you'll have these tuna cans full of.
Not just earwigs, but a lot of earwigs.
Yeah, a lot of earwigs, and other friends too. If none of those are really working for you, if your infestation is so big, which is what we have going on in this garden.
Yeah, we really do.
It's a pretty bad infestation. So yesterday, we resorted to a chemical solution. So Seven Works.
There are others.
There are many others. You just want to make sure that you read the label.
Follow the label exactly.
Exactly. That it's registered for earwigs.
Earwigs and the crop you're spraying it on.
So this is registered for vegetables and it's also registered for earwigs. I checked that when I bought it just to make sure.
And then it'll have a harvest interval that you have to wait before you harvest anything.
Yeah, we have to wait so many days, and I think it's a week on this one. You'll just follow those directions, get that down. This comes in a dust, it comes in a spray like this, and this is the less expensive option to mix it yourself, or it comes pre-mixed. So you can use that as well. But you're gonna have to stay on top of it. We're probably gonna have to reapply. It's not a one application thing, so.
Nope.
Yeah. So that's earwigs in the garden. It'll give you a bunch of ways to fight.
And good luck with that.
Good luck.
And thanks for watching.
Follow us. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
Follow us on Facebook, on Instagram, and something else.
YouTube. Garden Guys and Gal. We'd love to see you online and on those social media sites. So thanks for watching. Have a great day.